Hi, today we're here at the Swiss Consulate with Lucinda Ruh, ice skater and who won several world championships. So Lucinda, can you tell us a little bit more about yourself and where are you from?
Hi, well, first of all, I want to say thank you so much for having me. It's an honor to be here. I'm from Switzerland. My parents are from Zurich area, and I was born in Zurich, and I lived my first couple of months there, but quickly moved to Paris when I was 4 months old, and when I was 4 years old, moved to Tokyo. So I've kind of lived all around the world. I've lived in China as well, in Canada, and then throughout the States. But most of my years were actually growing up in Tokyo.
Okay. So when did you start figure skating?
I think the first time I've been on the ice was like when I was 4 years old, because my sister skated, and she's 9 years older than I, and so my mom was always at the rink with the bassinet, and she's like, you know, why don't you just get on the ice too? So that's how I started. But I really, really started skating hard when I was like 7, 8 years old in Tokyo.
Okay, so you're well known for holding the world record of spinning. So how did you become the queen of spin?
Yeah, I'm named the queen of spin in the skating world because I spin 6 rotations a second. So I'm the fastest spinner on ice in the world. And I'm also the longest spinner on ice. I have a Guinness World Record for 115 rotations on 1 foot. And I did that actually here in New York and also on the Today Show. But how I got there, my dad used to go to Switzerland a lot for his business trips. And he came back once and he's like, you know what? If you're going to skate and you're going to be an athlete, he's like, I don't mind if you're going to win gold medals. Shouldn't be your aim. It shouldn't be your goal. It's like, do something that nobody else has done. And Switzerland already kind of has a little tradition of spinners. So he's like, you should be the fastest spinner on ice in the world. Leave your name in history. So he told me that when I was about 7 years old. And it's kind of a big feat for a little girl. But I was like, you know, I want to make my dad proud. And so I kind of took that concept and I worked on it every single day, like hours and hours. My mom was kind of like my coach in the spins. And every day she's like, faster, longer, faster, longer. And so, here I am now, queen of spin. So I guess it was worth it.
Yeah, that's really an amazing career and really interesting. So how many times have you competed for Switzerland, actually?
Well, it's kind of hard to say like how many times because there's so many competitions, that you do, and you compete at nationals and then you compete internationally. But I am 2-time Swiss national champion, and I've been actually 8 times to the world championships. And then I'm 3rd in the world professional, 2x actually bronze medalist in the world professional. So, wow, how many times? I mean, you could say it's about 100 times you compete for your own country throughout your career. But that's just like an estimate. But I've been lucky enough to do the Grand Prix circuit and, you know, tour all around the world to compete and be honored to compete for my own country. So.
Okay. Well, it's really interesting. And besides competing all around the world, what brought you to New York, actually?
Well, I was coming to the States more because I was the fastest spinner in the world, and that was kind of my niche. And so we wanted to capitalize on it in the professional world. And all the shows, like Stars on Ice, Champions on Ice, all the world professional competitions at that time were in the States. So we decided it would be best for me in my career to come over to the States. So New York being, you know, capital of the world, kind of the city that everyone wants to be in. And if you can make it in New York, right, you can make it anywhere. So New York it was. And from there, you know, then it's, I mean, you live in New York, but you're still touring. I mean, I was on Stars on Ice, which is one of the most prestigious professional tours in the skating world. So I toured with them, and you tour about, you know, 80 cities throughout the States and Canada. So you're on the road for about 7 months of the year, but still New York was my home.
Okay. Wow. Sounds amazing. So now that you're living in New York, do you have any projects besides ice skating?
I continuously to do. I mean, I work a lot with many different charities, like Project Sunshine. I do a lot with St. Jude's. So I'm always there and lending my support because that's very important to me, as I always did shows for these charities. So that's important. And I've also written my autobiography. It's called Frozen Teardrop. So that's available. I'm actually working on a children's series right now. And should be coming out next year or so. And then I have twins of my own, 2 little girls that are 21 months old. So to say I'm busy is, you know, saying the least. I have a lot on my plate. And of course, I again, share my support for when there's skating shows that come for the charities and stuff. I lend my support and appear there as well. So, and I also teach. I give a lot of seminars. I've been to France and Japan and working with their Olympic teams. And I have a lot of little young hopefuls that I really want to continue my sport and continue my knowledge onto them so they can be the best that they can be. So.
Well, Lucinda, thank you very much for this interview.
Thank you.
And I'm sure you're going to be inspiring a lot of young talents.
Thank you very much.